we're back.
Yeah.
Now, who is this?
I don't know.
Just because you went and said goodbye.
Oh, I gotta see.
Do you think that I will say goodbye?
Just because Wilbur Harrison.
Okay, Wilbur Harrison. Hey, what happened to your Cowboys?
They sat down, man.
It was good, though, because when's the last time Buffalo's been in?
Exactly.
1986, you know. You know, the funny thing was, Big Man Carmen at the Italian
Bar. Oh!
He was from Chicago. He was a Buffalo fan.
Right.
Every Super Bowl, you know, $5, you know, a large sandwich, a couple beers, you know. So, you know, but every year, you know, there's like, you know, just, well, I'm standing there and then, Mama Jean's like, yo, Carmen, what's this? Oh, there's slips, you know.
Oh, she found his Benton slips.
Yeah. Well, how many did you get? Oh, just a couple. It's like, damn it, Carmen, this is number 10. How many of these?
Oh, my God.
It's every time, and, you know, and then before the game, they had Jim Kelly on there.
Oh, wow.
Did you see, that?
No, I was working, dude. No, honestly, I worked.
And then they showed the clip when it was wide left, you know. It's like, you know, what a heartbreak. Four times they never won it. Yeah, Jim Kelly.
Yeah. Man, that's a heartbreaker, really.
But hey, you're in the echelons of coaches who actually made it. There's a positive note.
Oh, yeah.
And that's still a very few. Exclusive club,
sure, you know. Man.
It, like, honest to God, there's not very many starting quarterbacks in the in the world, you know, like pitchers for that kind of, you know.
That was over at the antique place, you know. Saw some football cards, you know.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Ken Slater from the Raiders.
Wow.
Baseball cards.
Steve, I wonder if I could get Michael's number from Ronnie. And just tell Ronnie, I want to deal specifically with him and show him, have him stop by the house and show him some of the stuff that I got and see if he would make an offer on some of the stuff Mike's got.
Oh, really? Yeah, why not? You know.
She would be enamored to be able to make, you know. Here's my deal. I have a few lines, although I'm all for getting rid of stuff, there's a few things I won't do. One is heirlooms, one is something that she got. That she purchased that is dear to her, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
This is just stuff that was given that is another thing of China or another thing of so-and-so that she has extra. It's packed away that she didn't realize she has a full set of this and that.
Right.
And I said, if I could get rid of just that stuff and make you $1,000 or $2,000,
sure,
and still have stuff left over to do it again, would you do it? She's like, yes.
And I said, it would pay for the rawest trip to Myrtle Beach next summer.
Of course it would, you know. I said, Mom, you could, for the first time ever, like, within 2 weeks, pay for all of the trip. Like, $5,000 or $6,000, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Which is usually how much it costs for all the costs for the whole family to go. Five of us. Or four of us.
Sure.
You know, it's about three or four for the room for the week.
It'd help out the family budget.
Yeah. And I said, Mom, it'd make me feel better, you know, to know that it went somewhere good. I said, truth is, I would like to have it on display. I said, I tell you what, we could sell some of the stuff that's not a part of sets, and get and with that money, get a curio to where some of the stuff that would fit into it, this lit, or nice china hunts.
Yeah.
And I said, and we would still have enough stuff left over to where she could make $5,000 or $10,000. I said, there's always a way to display your stuff and make money to pay for a trip.
Yeah.
You know, make extra money. And I said, you wouldn't make $10,000 in 12 years of yard selling. You know? Now, I was involved 2 years ago.
Right.
I'm pretty good at the gift of gab. It's like I kissed a Barney stone, I guess. I set up for my mom in Sherwood Avenue yard sale. Ran all the stuff, tables, everything. As I'm setting up, I saw this guy pull up. His girlfriend's driving his $60,000 truck. He's a construction guy. He's plastered, lit. You know, he's even got his own little glasses there with him, you know. So he's like Dean Martin getting out of the country version of Dean Martin getting out of the truck. He's like, I'm just loving some of these pictures that I'm seeing up here. I'm like, oh, do you now?
Oh, yeah.
I said, well, we're not open. We're not going to sell it until tomorrow. I got cash on me now, and I'll make an offer on something. Right. Make an offer?
Yeah.
I'm about to put a sticker on some of this stuff for $1. And he's talking about starting out, he'll give me 25 for one of them.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, well, that's 24 more than I was asking for. Can you do 30 at least? You know? So it ended up, before this guy was there for 15, 20 minutes. I get mom involved for five of it.
Yep.
She don't know what's going on. By the time he leaves, Steve, I had $260 in cash.
Wow.
And I told mama, I said, if I give you $200, will you not even have the yard sale tomorrow? She said, Eddie, you wouldn't even make that. I said, you're right, here's $260. I said, let me get involved in some of your stuff and sell it and make you money, you know?
Yeah.
I still, mom, still, I had to take a nerve pill when I think about the Atari system she sold with
me. Oh, dude, man.
That's $10,000 right there alone.
I know.
With the games outside of the system. Somewhere we have Jarby, which is one of the characters from Star Wars that had the vinyl coat that's about $13,000 outside of the box.
You want to see some of the stuff over at the antique place.
Wow.
Stuff like when I was a kid, you know.
That's why. I found a Fisher Price 1952 clock that teaches kids how to tell time.
Yeah.
I'm like, mom, this is great. She's like, that's dirty. I'm like, this is what they want.
Dude,
yes.
Man. Dude, what?
The table that they're sitting on is from 1940 something,
right.
And it's your early version of your toy companies that made a table with puzzles and princes and dolls and
carousels.
But the table itself was valuable. Came from Ellen. Mom didn't know. You know, she thought about tossing it. I'm like, that's
what
I said. The antique that you have sitting on top that's worth $1.50 isn't worth the $1,500 that the table sitting on. That's the truth, though.
Right,
And I've told my dad, it's not what you think is valuable, you guys. I'm not saying I'm smarter than you, but I've studied this out.
Yeah.
And I've talked to Ellen. There's texts on these antique websites that'll give you email support where you take a picture, you show them, you describe. They'll tell you good, bad, or indifferent. They'll give you an honest opinion.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Rolling Stone needs to do it because they're big. Their internet and their online social.
Oh, it's too much longer.
Okay.
Mrs. Memphis Slim.
Okay.
But no, you need to get those American guys in your house.
I know, man.
Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the $4 item, and that's stretching it on a good day. He's saying $250. I'm like, can you make it $360 maybe?
Oh, yeah.
You know, it breaks my heart to let it go. And I'd sell you the whole half side of the attic for $300. You want $300 for that?
Yeah. Right, yeah, man.
You got it.
You know, the Ross Estates is a treasure trove.
Yes. It's just, it's crazy. Like, somewhere. Yeah, it's not been found yet.
Right.
I've never did a comprehensive breakdown of pulling everything out of as you're sitting on this couch in the sitting room where I like to stay.
Yeah.
The left side of the attic, that's never been thoroughly
gone through
from back end up. The one on the right side has.
Yeah.
And although that's gotten trashed up in the last few months, I know where everything is. This one over here is where all the old, it's your graveyard of electronics, paint, computers, every electronical system in the house is in there. So just to, I might move a 150-pound item and it only be nothing but the jacks that connect, it'd be hundreds of these jacks, you know, for a certain component or whatever. It's crazy. Like I told Dad, I could make an itemized list. All I gotta do is just talk into my phone. And then at the end of the day, this app sorts through what I have. We'll do research. We'll give you up to minute. You pay for it a little bit. Give you up to minute of what everything's worth. But most importantly, it makes an itemized list of everything that I have, where it could be located. A schematic of the room itself. Like you just set it down and it does a laser.
Yeah.
It's cool. Like the phone's more innovative than you think it is. But Dad's like, well, I just don't feel like going up there. I said, in all fairness, Bob, did the right hand side, and I made sure I didn't involve mom nor you.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So both hands go.
So, but I make sure that, I mean, I'm very, Chris would not be so caring about some stuff. He might even, not on purpose, but let some stuff go. He wouldn't know. You gotta go through it. What might be trash on top, underneath might be some pictures of my grandparents or great grandparents in the early days. I told Chris, you gotta go through, that's the bad thing, you gotta go through everything.
Oh, yeah.
So, I actually finished that up the week that Todd and his Boss were working on the house.
Oh, yeah.
They were reglazing the windows at that time. Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Which was labor intensive, but.
Oh, yeah. Well, it had to be done.
This is good.
Who is this?
I don't know, but I like that. He's got a Chuck Berry kind of sound. Come on, baby, let's do the twist. You know, he's got that kind of sound. I'll check the Christmas tree for water.
Yeah.
I'll check the plug-ins, make sure there's no plug-in thing now. Sometimes I'll reconfigure it because he'll not want to add anything and get underneath and unplug a bunch of stuff to get something that he'll use. And I'll go and do it. If I'm going to put it out, we're going to put it out right. You know, I told him one time he wouldn't run like 4 or 5 feet of lights on one side and then all the way up on the other. I'm like, no, that doesn't even aesthetically look right.
Oh, yeah.
I might be Uncle Eddie from National Lampoon's, but at least I'm going to make it look good.
Oh, yeah, man.
We'll be back after these messages. Southern Belle?
Oh, yeah. Radica Toys?
Yeah, Radica.